welcome to a vlog. You've been watching me tidy, just having a Saturday at home basically, tidying up because the house was a tip. Just was making a sweet potato stew. Another thing I forgot to move is this jumper. I need to go upstairs. But the kitchen still needs tidying. I just feel like, you know, suddenly you wake up one morning and you're like, God, I live in a mess, everything's a mess, I'm so messy. It's basically how I was feeling. Today's Saturday, like I just said, and I'm potting around all day today and then going to a friend Simon's birthday party this evening at his house, which I'm really looking forward to, so that would be nice. But yeah, I just thought I'd come on and start vlogging basically. Was feeling in the mood, or I turned all the books around at the bookshelf upstairs in my bed. Still has not the same effect if it was actually the spine of the book and they were all of a certain colour. But anyhow, I'm just gonna stay. I'm about to make myself coffee, even though it's like 3 o'clock. I was a bit hungover today. Went out for dinner and drinks last night and really didn't drink that much, but I think we had we had a bottle of wine each, I guess. But with dinner, I mean, that is a lot, but with dinner and over the course of an evening, I was so hungover this morning. I don't know if you guys get this too, like sometimes you can drink, like have a skinful and wake up the next morning and you're like, I'm okay, this is fine. Other times you don't have as much and you wake up the next morning like, oh God, this is the end. It was me this morning. I feel better now, thankfully. So yeah, I'm gonna make some coffee. And yeah, I've got some bits and bobs to show you as well in a bit, which I will do. And yeah, ended up getting more of these coffee pots. I had a bloody nightmare with it. I don't even like them anyway, but it's because there's a Shoreditch grinders near me, whereas there's not an espresso shop near. So went in, bought them, and they have ground coffee in the pods. I said, can I get some of the pods? Gave me it. Didn't bloody read it till I got home. He gave me the ground coffee, which I opened it, so I couldn't then go back and, I don't know, I would never want to go back and be like, somebody get this wrong, and it's not very British to complain about stuff like that, is it? Those are boring stories. Then I went back and got the pods. It took me 2 trips to go and get coffee that I don't even like or want. Just running myself a bath. Start the book that I'm currently reading, which is The Sellout. So I haven't started it yet. I've been really bad at reading this week. I haven't read for 2 days. And I just want to show you something that I love to have in my bag. I've got this for Christmas. Susan Kaufman Oil Bath and Senses. And it's just beautiful. And it has a sprig of rosemary in it. Which makes sense, doesn't it? And it's so good. Honestly. Smell. She also has the de-stress oil, which is really good. And I'm becoming a big fan of this brand. I also want to talk to you. Let's go into the bedroom so that we can't hear the bath running. We ordered what is like one of the best products ever, which is fur oil. I've talked about it before, but I just wanted to mention it again. So I mostly use it on my bikini line if I'm shaving my bikini line a lot, but you can use it anywhere. And it's just to sort of keep the skin I don't know about you, but sometimes shaving your bikini line a lot is just not good for the skin, and it, you get ingrown hairs and it gets bumpy and all sorts. But that stuff is so good, so good. So I get the ingrown concentrate, it's called, and the one that's just called fur oil. You get it on like Cult Beauty, but it's brilliant. Really recommend it. Good morning, guys. Sunday morning. Just been doing some work. Pottering about, had a nice evening last night and didn't drink much, so I'm not hungover today, thankfully, just tired. How good is this jumper? It's from Suzanne. So good. I'll talk about it more in the monthly fashion report. But yeah, such a good one. So yeah, had such a nice evening. I think I was in bed by like 1, which wasn't so bad. And then today, this afternoon, we're going to meet up with Katie and we're going to do crazy golf. In town, which I'm really looking forward to. I'm going to take her to Cream Cookies before to get a cookie because I can't stop thinking about them all week long. So I just simply have to have one now. So that's the plan today. And before that, got some more pieces from Netta Porter to talk to you guys about, which I did the first part of the collaboration with them last month, and then was explaining
They have a section online called Net Sustain, and the way that I've been working with them is to pick out pieces that they loan to me to try and share with you guys, and they send them all back, which is a really nice way to work with a brand. So this time I picked pieces all from the Net Sustain section, and they update it. So last time when I was picking, there wasn't as much as then when I went this time. I was like, oh my gosh, there's so much on this section. So it's worth always checking in with it as well, because they update it all the time, obviously, as the site updates generally. So yeah, I've got some bits, and they're all from that category, which is really nice. All from some different brands too that I haven't tried before, just to see what they were like and swoon over some very beautiful items of clothing, which we shall do now. Right, first up, we've got some jeans. These are from a brand called Gold Sign. When I did my testing base at denim, I really nearly included these, but in the end went for a gold instead. And I know lots of people who really like this brand. They're kind of, it's expensive, it's a similar price to just any premium denim brand. But I've been wanting a pair of washed black. So I've got my Toe 10 washed black ones, but I've been wanting a pair of ones that are slightly straighter leg. So I thought I'd try these. They are super expensive. I think they were like £300 maybe. And I would, if I wanted to go for these, I think I'd need to go for a size down than I have here. But they fit so much nicer than the gold ones. I wish I'd done this brand in the testing basics when I did that denim, because I remember I talked about how not I didn't like the redone ones as well. But these have such a nice fit to them. Like, not too baggy on the leg, not too skinny either. Like, the length is really, really, really good. Like I say, they just are a bit big for me, like over the crotch and stuff here, so I would just need a waist size down. But these are really good. What do you think? This, like, because I'd wear them with boots for now while it's still cold, and then with like my loafers and stuff through the spring. But then you could also, like, just this, imagine this with a tank top and some slides and some cool black sunglasses and a lovely handbag. Like, just so simple. And my Toe 10 ones I've worn to death and have loved styling that colour of jean. Oh, these are really bloody good. I would just need one size smaller. Such a good length too. Okay, this is the first piece. Right, next up we have a cardigan. This is from a brand called Azel, which I'll definitely have butchered the pronunciation of. And I thought it looked really cool online as a piece that you could just wear, like, in the spring, obviously, when you would wear a cardigan without any layers. But in real life, I don't like it as much. It's got these amazing sleeves, but it's the fabric looked, I mean, it's a really lovely wool, and the colour is gorgeous, but the fabric looked a lot thicker on the picture. And like on this arm, it kind of looks fine and it holds the shape, but on this arm, the shape isn't holding as much with the wool. So yeah, I mean, like I said, I think I really like this one button style. And this, I imagine like having your belt on and being able to see that through. And this colour with these colour jeans is definitely a good combination. But yeah, this wouldn't be something that I think I would opt to go for normally. But the brand generally had some really, really, really nice things. Like this sort of thing where it's a classic piece, but there's something a bit different about it, which I like a lot. Okay, this is so good. So I've been wanting a hoodie, a nice hoodie, not like a, you know, not like the kind of one you'd set at home in, which are still lovely, but something a bit different to wear, as I've styled it here, under a blazer. And this one is from a brand, it's, I think it's pronounced Basic, but it kind of looks like it's spelled Basique, but I think it's Basic, which is not eye-wateringly expensive by any means. This hoodie, which I'll take the blazer off in a minute. The blazer is just one I had already from Arquette. How good does this look with the string tie here? And it's got like, well, it's not a V-neck. I don't know what this neckline's actually called. It's quite a thin cotton hoodie, so really good for layering rather than getting bunched up under your armpits. You know, the kind of ones I'm thinking, the ones that I normally wear, like the Uniqlo ones, which are thick and fleecy and lovely, but you would get really bunched up layering them. I really like this whole outfit. I like wear this with loafers or with my Muji trainers now. These jeans are really, really winning me over. Oh, this is such a good outfit. But yeah, and this is so nice. I like the string thing, especially. Let me just take the blazer off one sec. Oops. Okay. So good. So it's got, let me show you again, hello. So it's quite like a boxy, wide fit. I'll be honest, I don't like how it looks as much on its own. I mean, I'd wear it for like around the house or on a flight or whatever, but I think it would very much be a layering piece for me. I mean, tucked in, it could look really good though, when it's got a bit more. I'm just doing a half fake tuck so that we can get an idea of what that might look like. Yeah, that gives it a bit more of a kind of shape and style to it. But this, I love stuff like this where you like layer and you've got your jewellery and it's really simple still, but just something that's a bit interesting and different and makes your everyday looks feel way more interesting. I really, really, really like this. Really like it. Oh, so good. Last piece to show you. Honestly, guys, I've nailed this order that I did. This is for a brand called Matto, which is an Australian brand, and you might mostly know them for their swimwear. They do beautiful swimwear. But this top, so I've been after, I think I mentioned this in a monthly fashion report not so long ago, a really simple, nice, sexy evening top that you will wear loads. Like, even if you don't wear it every day because it's more of an evening piece, but one you won't get tired of. This could be it. So I love the long sleeves. I love the fact it's quite short in the body, so you could easily just tuck it into your high-waisted jeans. This neckline is beautiful. Like, when you've got your hair up like this and big hoops in and stuff, so good. But it's the back that really is the winning feature. Look at that. Let me try and fully... So it's quite hard to film, as you can imagine. It's just got a tie here. It's so simple. So simple and so good. You've seen those pictures on Instagram that people do where they're like sat at a restaurant or a, you know, a bar having a glass of wine with their back out. This is the vibe. This is what I'm after. How beautiful is this? Oh, I feel like you could just wear, and I love stuff like this. You like, would go out and wear a blazer over it or whatever, a coat, whatever, and it doesn't look like much. And then when you take it off, when you get to where you're going, it just feels so special and different. I really like it. What do you guys think? Obviously, you can't wear a bra with it, but the fabric, you know, I'm not fussy about nipples anyway, but the fabric's really nice and thick, so you can barely see. I'm trying to show you in the light. You can barely see your nipples at all. Look at me trying to show you this. But it's a good thick fabric, so if that was something you'd be worried about with it being backless, so you can't wear a bra. I really, really like this. Oh, let me know what you think. Oh, it's beautiful. This and the hoodie and the jeans. The cardigan's the only thing I don't now really, really want, which isn't the idea of this. But this is just so nice. So nice. Oh. Right, I'm ready to go out. Thought I would show you what I'm wearing. My hair pulled back, which is different. Suzanne jumper, t-shirt underneath, I think it's an Everlane one. Gap men's jacket, Ami trousers, Muji trainers, Muji socks, classic. I really want a pair of bright blue socks. If anyone knows where to get them, let me know, because my God, I went in there to every shop in Shoreditch yesterday. I was like, there's definitely gonna be something in these like cool edgy shops. No, there was not. I failed. Oh my God, it's throwing it down. My face is soaking wet. Ooh, just watched drop some film off. Honestly, I'm drenched. Oh, this weather is the worst. Oh, sorry, I knocked you with the handbag. I'm just gonna have to put everything on a radiator. So bad. Oh my God. Oh, this is just grim. It's Monday afternoon. I've had such a mental day. Obviously, getting drenched in the rain, just tops it off nicely. Oh my gosh. Oh yeah. Well, my hair was sticking out from under my hat. I got myself a hot drink, because who would worry stuff like that when there's so much going around? It's just what tips you over the edge of having a cold. Oh yeah. Dear me. What are we gonna do with this weather? Been shooting, obviously, just indoors, because, you know, it's not just drizzle.
And yeah, I really just had to drop that film off today. Otherwise, I would have not walked out in such conditions. Hey, I need to like, I've got so much to do, I need to pack for Copenhagen. I'm not gonna vlog Copenhagen. I was thinking of trying to create a video when I was there about what inspires me, like when I'm traveling, especially as it's fashion week, there'll be lots of cool people there. So yeah, I thought I might do something, I don't know, just film bits on my phone about that and make like a more observational video of what inspires me about obviously seeing people at Fashion Week, where everyone is fashionable, but also just being in a different city and stuff. So that's the plan for that. Hi guys, I'm just continuing this vlog in Copenhagen on my phone. And like I said, I'm gonna do a bit of a different video for Copenhagen, but I thought I would show you what my Fashion Week outfits are. I have, so like a bit, this could be a video in itself, but I guess I'll just put it within this vlog. And I'll do a blog post with Copenhagen recommendations separately so that everything you may wish for will be available. The thing about Fashion Week is it is like an intimidating scene at times. So I've only packed clothes that I love to wear all the time, so I feel as much like me as possible, which I just think is the best way to go about it. So today I've got on a very old thermal, which is from Next. It's a really good one because it's cold here. Arts and Spencer's cashmere jumper, Old Blues necklace, my Totem jacket, Ami trousers, black socks, and my Proenza shoes. And I'm just gonna take my Sophie King bag and put an Everlane knit over my shoulders. And that is today's look. I actually can't remember the last bit of vlogging I did before this. Sorry, I thought I'd talk to you like this as opposed to through the camera. In fact, I'm gonna do up my laces while I talk to you. I can't remember the last bit of vlogging I did. I've been super all over the place this week. It's only like Wednesday or something. Feels like it's about Friday, or even like there's a new day of the week that's been added on to the end of all of this. But yeah, I know I've got all sorts of bits and bobs in this vlog, which I hope has been okay. Like I said about last week, I think it's quite representative of where my mind's at the moment, which I don't mind as long as you guys don't mind. Armed with Compeed, because these shoes still hurt. And what's that noise? And I'm just going to go out to meet a friend for some coffee before we start doing all of the Fashion Weeky bits. Hey guys, day two outfit. Gone for all cream. My Totem jumper, long sleeved Under the Stories t-shirt underneath. These are the new Levi's jeans I mentioned. So they sent me them in white and like a mid-wash. I'll show you the mid-wash tomorrow when I travel in them. The fit of them is so good. They're called the Collin. And they're just perfect. These white ones are super, super, super soft as well. And they've got like a blue stitching on them. So I'm going for those. Some blue socks, which are from Arquette. Proenza shoes again, which I think I finally managed to break in. I wore them all day yesterday and didn't have any issues. And then I'm just gonna put on my big Ray coat over this whole outfit to keep warm because it's miserable and rainy and cold today. Right, here we have it with the coat. Which is so overwhelming, really. It just, the whole outfit gets lost under it, but it's so cold here. So practicality has taken over. My Sophie Hume Bolt bag. I'm just taking out my contacts. I've got my Mamiya with me and I took it out yesterday morning to shoot some stuff, but for going to shows and stuff, it's pretty cumbersome. I don't mind doing like a city break with it if I'm walking around on my own. But when you're in and out, jackets on and off, it's just a bit much. So I might come back later to get it so I can shoot on it, but I have to go because I'm running late. Hello guys, I'm back home now. Just got some sweet potato on my face. Just had a baked sweet potato with tuna. And I've just finished editing the vlog. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but I've been trying to do like one vlog a week and then a different type of video that's not a vlog. And it's been allowing me to vlog sort of less, I guess, because you have a whole week to do it. Which is how I always used to vlog when I was in Manchester. I think I was a bit more like together and organized back then, because when I'm watching these back, they're really just sporadic. I personally really like it. I think it's because it feels quite representative of how I am at the moment.
But yeah, I hope you guys aren't minding it. Like I said, I'm really liking it. Just, I don't know, I'm also aware it's a bit sporadic is the best word for it, but I do hope you're enjoying it. Watching it back, I was like, oh, that really just feel like how my week has just felt, so that's quite nice. And obviously amazing to be working with Etta Porter again, so I'm super excited about that, and I hope you guys enjoyed that segment of the video especially, and the fact it was all, that was sort of the feedback you guys gave last time, that you wanted all the pieces to be from the Net Sustain section, because there was lots of Totem, which isn't a sustainable brand, so this time did all the Net Sustain. Should I get that Matto top, I think. Should I? I took some pictures in it as well, while I had it here, and I really want it. Anyway, let me know what you guys think. There was something else I was gonna, oh, the Levi's jeans that I'd said I was gonna show you in the mid-wash. They're in the washing machine as we speak because I got beetroot on them at dinner when I was in Copenhagen. You guys know I like try to never wash my jeans. So I'm so annoyed, I've literally worn them twice and they're already in the washing machine as we speak. But I suppose it'll be a good test for them quite early on. So not the next video. The next video will be my Copenhagen like inspiration one. The one after will be the monthly fashion report. So I'll talk about them in there and show you them then. And because they'll have been washed, at least maybe I can give a bit more of an insight into them. But I was so annoyed because I would really never wash denim that quickly after getting it. But it had literally beetroot all over. That was, oh, the other thing I want to talk about was books, because in the vlog I was saying that I was starting The Sellout by Paul Beattie. Do you ever read a book and it's not you're not enjoying it, but you're like, this isn't the book for me right now. That was what happened. I read like the first maybe 20 pages, if that, and I was like, I'm going to come back to it. I'm not giving up on it like I did A Brief History of Seven Killings, but it's just not the book for me right now. So I've put that down. And then I read Lanny by Max Porter. I think I maybe talked about that already, which I loved. Loved, so good. And then I read Eleanor Oliphant is Completely Fine by, I've forgotten the name of the author already. I want to say Gail something, but maybe not. No, it was fine. It was like a really easy read, but didn't love it. And then on the flight to Copenhagen, I read by John le Carré, The Spy That Who Came In From the Cold. I feel like I didn't follow it. I don't know if I wasn't concentrating enough, because then I got to the end and I was like, oh my God, that was such a good story, and I don't feel like I was appreciating enough as it went. It's a spy novel. I gave it 3 stars on Goodreads, but I think maybe I need to read it again or maybe watch the film to get a bit of an idea of it, because it wasn't a complicated read. I don't know what it was. Maybe just my headspace and that book didn't match. Because yeah, the ending I was like, I think that was really good, but I feel like I don't really know what I just read. And now I've started The English Patient, and I'm about 60, 70 pages in, and I already really like it. And I love the film of that book, and I haven't seen the film in a really long time. But the book already I'm really enjoying. So that's my reading updates, which I've sort of shoehorned into the end of this mental vlog. But like I said, I hope you've enjoyed it. I'm in a vlog, Mum's coming down tonight, and I'm just gonna vlog throughout next week, and I'm sure you'll get something similar to this in a week or so, unless my headspace settles down. Please tell me it's not just me that it's this time of year or something, but I am like up the wall and around the bend every single day with something or other, and I really hope it isn't just me. It's something in retrograde, that's what I always put it down to, a planet. It's not my fault, it's the solar system. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.